While I was thinking about Joseph Smith in Liberty Jail, it's not the well-quoted verse that things shall be but a small moment that gave me perspective, but seeing how Joseph had spent his time while locked up, while the saints are suffering and being murdered, the prophet is pleading with the Lord for things to be over and things to be different. And what happened? Well, months passed and he's still in jail. But just because time seems to be standing still doesn't mean that God is. And just because we may be waiting doesn't mean that we are to be idle. Now, when I first moved to Utah when I was 21, everyone joked, saying like, if you move to Utah, you're going to get married like that. And it's not that that's what I wanted. I was terrified of marriage, but years had passed and I'm still single. Now, this isn't about marriage, so bear with me. It's about like those really long seasons and things don't seem to be changing. So while these years are passing and I'm still very single, you know, you have like, you get in your mind, right? And so I'm starting to wonder like, well, what's wrong with me? What am I doing wrong? Why am I being overlooked? Like, is there something wrong with me? Am I flawed? Am I not good enough? Like, where is Christ with this blessing, with this righteous desire I have? And then we get into the all too familiar dance with the adversary when, with passing time, we allow him to run rogue with our thoughts. The more time that passes, the more we become consumed with it all. And it took me a little while to learn this lesson, this life-changing counsel to cope with these long, hard seasons that come to us. I think of the revelation Joseph Smith received while captured, the many chapters in D&C that we wouldn't have if Joseph decided to shut down from his situation, if Joseph had allowed the adversary in his mind any longer with those negative thoughts that keep us standing still or moving back. That maybe it's not just about making it out alive or dragging ourselves to the end, but what if, like it was with Joseph Smith, that it's about what we get during it all. So in my single years, I decided I'm tired. I'm tired of wondering and doubting and time counting. Do you ever do that? Time count? Like, what kind of living is that? That's not living. I was going to worry about me and I'm going to worry about God. And I decided to just stay focused on what matters most and what's important to me. I was going to worry about the relationship I did have, the one that I have, you know, with God. I figured if we aren't doing the things that we love, if we're putting those things on pause, we're missing the point. And that is when life started to unravel and just blossom in ways I never would have imagined. I learned a lesson I couldn't imagine living life without. I grew beyond what I thought I could in such a short time. Truth is, I'm not sure what kind of wife or person I would be without the qualities I gained and the lessons I learned and the talents I developed while I was single or while we are waiting, right? Because I'm such a better person because of them. It was through that season of like waiting that I started writing and I started speaking and I started to become who I am today and who I was meant to be and who I strongly believe God intended me to be all along. When we're trying and a trial hasn't ended yet, decide to be productive with your time. Actively seek out the lessons and the opportunities. Move forward with the things you know you should be doing and what God wants you to do. Move forward knowing that though we wonder why he hasn't arrived yet and where are your promised blessings or where is this protection, you know, God knows something we don't. There will always be something to overcome, something hard to handle, or something new to figure out, and how unproductive it is to long for a trial to be over, to crave a fast forward button, to hang on to this make-believe mortal vision we create in our minds. Turn anger and confusion into productive experiences that allow you to grow in the greatest ways. Having that mindset will chase away anger or bitterness and turn your trying times into productive learning and growing times. We're allowed to feel deflated. We're allowed to struggle. We're allowed to feel sad or upset. But it's up to us whether or not we choose to live there. The adversary will stay as long as we allow him to. But we have a literal power to cast him out, a power he has to obey. If we're trying, we will never be asked to go through something that isn't for the absolute best. Lessons and growth are there. God, he's there. Things may not go the way that we want and pray them to, but they will always be profoundly better than what we even knew was available to ourselves. Sometimes we can't help but think how much easier it would be if things had gone the way we wanted them. But little do we know what's right around the corner for us when we choose to remember God. Opportunities that wait, the people, the growth, the blessings, because truly the best things come from God. You may be in a hard or long season right now, but seasons don't last forever. Just because things haven't worked out yet doesn't mean they won't. Promised blessings don't expire. Passing time can't dim blessings promised to us. Write them down, remember them, and hang on for a wild adventure with lessons and experiences you wouldn't ever trade. Don't allow passing time to bring doubt or cause you to settle. Don't lose patience and miss out on what he has in store for you. And in the meantime, don't hold yourself back from learning and growing and experiencing other things. Just hold on. Don't lose confidence. Heavenly Father knows what's important to you and what you need. His promises are so real. There are far, far better things that lay ahead, I promise. God, he promises. And that's what I love about him. You will never be shortchanged from the absolute best blessings ever. None of your efforts, none of your faith is in vain. So next time we wonder why and how much longer, remember the counsel given to Prophet Joseph Smith in Liberty Jail. The Son of Man hath descended below them all. Art thou greater than he? Therefore, hold on thy way. Because truly, it will all seem like a small moment. Because life here is a tiny little bead on a never-ending string going infinitely to the left and infinitely to the right. And sometimes we don't always know what, but we do always know the who. And I'm all in for whatever comes next. Your prayers, they have been heard. But greater is what he has in store for you.